Lucy, one of the recently evicted Big Brother Naija lockdown housemates, had an interview in which she highlighted Kidwire and Erica's relationship. She said that Erica wouldn't have stood a chance if Nengi really wanted Kidwire. Now, Lucy in an interview said Kid and Nengi are far better as a couple than Erica and Kid. Do you agree? Do you disagree?
I think Lucy is just a bitter woman.
she's just
a bitter woman. You can't say that about people's lives or relationship. You have no moral right. You have no justification whatsoever. And obviously, you have something against the lady.
Why doesn't she have the right to?
She doesn't have the right to say things like that. Why would you look at people and say they are not worthy to be together? That's what she's saying.
Everyone will always have an opinion about other people.
The fact that you just shared an opinion about her just now. She's a bitter person, and it's obvious. It's so revealed. If you're not on good grounds with Erica, it doesn't give you the right to talk her down like that. That's totally rubbish.
There's nothing wrong with what she said, because she's inside the house.
There's going to be heated, whatever. What does she mean by Nengi stands a better chance?
She's inside the house. She's seen a lot of things, even better than some of us outside.
Well,
so I think she has even more justification to say what she did, because she has seen a lot of things that even the camera were unable to capture. So she probably has a reason for that. And even me watching the lockdown show, I kind of like see where she's coming from, and I do feel like Kid and Nengi have more chemistry than Erica and Kid.
I don't think so. Nengi never gave Kid that feel initially. It was when Nengi started seeing Erica vibing with Kid and she started liking their kind of vibe. Obviously, Ozo was dulling Nengi, and Nengi needed somebody like Kid who was more outgoing and felt, why didn't I spot this guy earlier on? And she started warming up to Kid,
you know,
because Erica was already getting the vibe.
Do you know the reason I said so? Erica was always trying to kind of like curtail Kid's movement in the house. You know, you can't talk to this, you can't talk to that, you can't.
You
do
wouldn't
this,
blame her. She's trying to protect her man.
Of course she is, but the kind of Kid, the kind of person he seems to be, is the kind of person that Nengi seems to be as well. You know, this kind of free spirited person. You can't hold me down. I'm here to have fun. Which was what Nengi is about, and Kid as well. But Erica was that kind of person, like, look, you and I, it's you and I always, you and I, you have to be following each other up and down, you and I, you're in a competition. This is not ultimate love.
Erica,
you're in a competition, Big Brother Naija. If you're going to be evicted, you're not going to be evicted as a couple, which was what Erica found out at the end of the day.
Erica saw the way Nengi and Ozo were vibing, and she didn't think it was right for you to leave Ozo and come into vibe with my person that is making me feel happy in the house.
Did anybody sign a dotted line? Did they sign dotted lines that once we are together, we have to?
It is what it is.
What it is.
You were with Ozo. Don't suddenly depart from Ozo and come and disturb my own camp.
That's the thing. That was the downfall of Erica. Thinking, oh my gosh.
I don't think
gosh,
it was the downfall.
This is Erica once is we are not, together.
See, Erica is not defeated.
It is official. It means we're in a marriage. We're a couple. It means like, you know, I can't do any other thing. We are all chained together.
Who was in Lucy really good with in the house?
Doesn't happen like that, my G. Especially when the guy said,
who was the Lucy good with in the house?
Especially when the guy said categorically, like, you and I were just having fun.
That's one thing you can never hold against Kidwire.
He was quite open about what he wanted
from
Erica.
Open or not open,
but
Kidwire
was
chose
saying something
Erica
else and
over
doing
the others.
Another thing. She was like, that's you're my special friend. Meanwhile, you can't say that you and this guy are an official couple.
He chose Erica over the others. There's no crime in that.
How did he choose her?
He did.
How?
He went for her.
How?
If Nengi was the target, Kid would have gone for Nengi.
If he did go
for
her.
Are you telling me Kid is suddenly a cold brother when it comes to ladies?
If he did go for her, he wouldn't have given Nengi any attention at all.
No, you can't say that. They are in the house together. You can't expect him to be shown keeping malice with the Nengi. They didn't have it. They didn't have issues now.
Did Erica and Kid go into the house together?
Let's not do this thing as if we don't know what's up now.
They can leave each other in the house. Which was what happened.
If Kid wanted Nengi, he would have never given Erica that opportunity.
Why?
He would have gone straight for Nengi.
I
know you like me, but I don't send you Nengi I like. He would have gone for Nengi. Slug it out with Ozo. But obviously, Kid also saw that Ozo really likes this girl. Let me not even kill his vibe. Let him continue doing what he's doing.
But here's the thing. No one is tied to each other's strings at
Nobody's
all.
Saying
exactly.
That.
We're so
saying
they're all individuals.
You guys
here.
Should let Erica be, for God's sake.
Hold it right there. Kid and Nengi, or Erica and Kid. Who do you think is a better couple?
Erica Nengi. Erica Kidi.
Can I just speak? Hashtag Max Breakfast. Away from that, we have Actress Shan George, who is engaged. The 50-year-old, who is a grandmother, is given marriage a third chance. She posted a beautiful photo of her ring on Instagram, and she said, "As scared and skeptical as I've been all this past years, based on unfavorable past experiences, this one seems to be just too right to be afraid of or to hide. So I said, yes, let's try again this one last time. It's never too late. Yes, I love you too." Well, according to the veteran actress, her fiance is from Cross River State, which is also her home state. Oh. And I saw the comment section, people were like, this woman, you're too old to be doing this. You're too old. I'm like, come on. Never too late to find love.
And she equally said the person is like her friend, a confidant. Obviously, they've been together for a long time, and she felt it was time to do it again. So I didn't see anything wrong in that.
Oh, this life is just one. Have to just keep just trying.
Live happily.
If you say, I've been married once before, I can't do it again because of what people will say.
True.
It's your life at the end of the day.
Yes, a lot of people have made some very crazy decisions because of what people will say. And these people that are even contributing to your life, so they have not even given you a dime in your life. I don't know why people really take people's thoughts into consideration a lot. Sad.
All right then. Tiwa Savage has revealed in an interview that she almost quit music after backlash from Love Me, Love Me, Love Me, Love Me back in 2010. The video also got banned by the NBC here in Nigeria. She said she was told that this is too sexy, you can't be this.
Come on.
But she was able to bounce back from that incident back in 2010. And this is 2020, of course. She hasn't backed out from being sexy.
She's a fighter.
Yeah.
That video wasn't bad.
You know how it is. We've seen
more terrible videos.
This was 2010 back then. So I guess little by little.
They almost killed my lady's vibe now. She's always one of my very favorite artists, I'm telling you.
Celebrity crush?
Yeah, she did a voice drop for me sometime.
No. You didn't answer the question. And everybody celebrity kept wondering, crush.
Do you know what it means for Tiwa Savage to endorse you as a handsome guy?
Oh my God. Is she your celebrity crush?
Mark the soldier, the handsome, the lovely Mark the soldier. No, man. She gave me that accolade years ago, and I will never forget. I'm going to get her on Instagram Live very soon, and we're going to have to vibe together. I'll play it for her. See, this is what you did for me when I started my career, and everybody started vibing. Tiwa Savage don't endorse this guy. They wanted to know Mark.
Are you back now?
And funny enough, my picture was not online.
Okay.
Are
you back now?
I'm here, babe.
Okay, so
nowhere.
Is she your celebrity crush?
What do you mean celebrity crush? I love her.
Oh my God.
Oh, celebrity crush.
I don't know. Okay, let's just
that's
move
not
on.
To be used for
let's
legends.
Just move on.
Move on to where?
To the abroad. 62-year-old Hollywood actor Alec Baldwin and 36-year-old wife Hilaria have welcomed their fifth child together, a baby boy. Well, Alec is also father to 24-year-old Ireland with ex-wife Kim Basinger. Ellen DeGeneres has announced the date for the return of her talk show on the 21st of September, as she has promised to address the workplace scandal. Some of her workers went an anonymous tip saying that she treated her staff badly, it was a toxic workplace and blah blah blah. So she says she's coming back to address the issue live on her show. And lastly, Ronald Callies Bell, a co-founder and singer of the group Kool and the Gang, has died. He was 68 years old. Quite sad. May he soul rest in peace. And that is what we have this morning on Entertainment Street.